right, so now what we're going to do is, if you remember here when we talked about in the skull, we had the ethmoid bone. So I'm going to take the ethmoid bone here. Imagine it being in this position right here. I'm going to yank it out. We're going to look at that, okay? That little shark fin structure that's coming off right there is actually called the Crista Galli. Okay, that's the Crista Galli of the ethmoid bone. Then, if you remember before, I said there's like a plate here that's running right here. And it's, there's little holes in it. Might be able to notice some of the little holes. Those little holes are called the olfactory foramina. But that plate that has all that holes in it is actually going to be called the cribriform plate of the ethmoid bone, all right? And then inside of this, just like we talked about with the sphenoid, it has these little ethmoidal air cells, which is where, again, that's the hollow cavity there that, you know, can contain some mucus, and that's going to be called the ethmoid sinus. And again, that would actually be a paranasal sinus, meaning that it drains into the nasal cavity. All right, next thing. If you look here, we got a little thing moving right down the middle, this little piece moving right down the middle. You can see a little bit of it there too. That's called the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid bone. That's actually what helps to form a part of the nasal septum, that and the vomer. Then if you look, you have these little chunks of things right up here and then a little chunk right there. These are called your superior nasal conchae, okay? Now if I come down more, this is actually gonna be called the middle nasal conchae, and this is gonna be a middle nasal conchae. Okay, so we got superior nasal conchae up here, middle nasal conchae, and we got the perpendicular plate. All right, next thing, and here's where it gets a little funky. Sometimes people will kind of get a little confused, but if I take that chunk from that side of the perpendicular plate and that chunk, all that chunk right there that I'm holding in my right hand right here on this right side here, that's actually gonna be the right lateral mass. And if I hold this chunk over here, that's gonna be the left lateral mass. So all this chunk here from the perpendicular plate out here is the right lateral mass, and all this chunk over here from the left side of the perpendicular plate is the left lateral mass. Next thing is if you look here on the sides, these are actually gonna be called the orbital plates of the ethmoid bone. So this is the orbital plate of the ethmoid bone. And again, you would have one on this side also. So you would see these within the orbit. Okay, so for example, if I actually come in here and show you a little chunk of it, you might be able to see a piece of it right in there. That's actually gonna be the orbital plates of the ethmoid bone.